As usual, I recommend starting to get into the wrists, even if you think that you've been warming up a little bit before doing, I don't know what, whatever. It's always really good to get circulation happening into the wrists, good warm up, little stretch. So as usual, there's a few good stretches that I show you. You can also get hold of the thumb as well to get stretching into those forearms, shoulders, wrists, as we're gonna start very soon moving quite quickly through vinyasas. So you can go into namaskar and lift your elbows, trying to keep the heel of the hands together, shoulders relaxed. Can you see that? Yes, shoulders nice and relaxed. All right. Also, you can get on your hands. So if you're in Vajrasana, that's quite easy, which is the posture I recommend. And we're gonna start today with a breathing exercise, which I think is really important these days, just to make sure that you get your immune system in check, building up the immune system, strengthening the immune system, keeping it in check. So what we're going to be doing is what we call the breath of fire. So I keep seeing different things from different teachers. I think some teachers, unfortunately, I get a bit confused. Anyway, names don't matter so much, but breath of fire is really that breath that activates the fire at the core center. So we're going to be doing a bit of core today. So we'll start getting into the core using the breath, starting to bring up some heat. And again, very important to use the breath. It's always been very important, but it's like if you need to drop anything and keep the one thing, that's the one thing, the one practice that you need to keep is the breath. That's for sure. So the breath of fire is a pretty strong breath. So we do a couple of kriyas that you can use to also help getting a bit warmed up into the shoulders. So maybe still warming up into the shoulders whilst I demonstrate. You can roll your shoulders back and then forward, just reversing the whole process. So again, the breath of fire, very good to activate the core, activate the nervous system, and keep your immune system in check as we exhale nice and strong through the nose to get rid of all the toxins. You might have accumulated a few toxins over the weekend, so we're really trying to get that out. So these are short, sharp exhalation, inhales and exhales in and out through the nose. So that's what we call pastrika. So just quickly how it goes, if you don't wanna do any kriya with it, you can just keep your palms open to the sky and just feel. And again, you want to be using your abdominals, so I'll just quickly demonstrate. It goes like this. Deep inhale in through the nose, belly expands, out the nose, belly comes in. So we can go for, we'll do two rounds of 15 to 20. Whenever you feel this is enough, you can just relax. So we'll do one first round with the arms up. So as you inhale, you're gonna stretch your fingers up, opening your hands so that you stretch your fingers right up to the sky. And as you exhale out the nose, you're gonna bring your elbows in towards your chest, closing your hands into fists. And again, inhale, exhale. So we're gonna go with the breath, nice strong breath, paying attention to any difference of pressure into the ears. Let's get going, aiming for 15 at least, maybe 20. relaxing your hands on your lap, relaxing your breath, a couple of deep breaths, just feeling into the body. If you feel comfortable, we're gonna go maybe a little bit stronger with the breath, see if you can keep focusing on the navel movement along with the breath. Second Kriya, see if you can bring your palms to your shoulder blades, so touching your shoulders and maybe even past the shoulders onto the shoulder blades, elbows right up to the sky, so feeling the opening of the chest. And we do the same thing. Let's get going. Deep inhale in through the nose, pumping the abdomen out the nose, navel in. Deep inhale, exhale, relaxing your hands on your lap, just letting the breath relax for a moment, gently opening your eyes, and you can now come onto your all fours. So we're going to get onto the wrist a little bit more, starting to now getting a bit of loading happening on the wrist, so just getting any free form cat and cow, maybe just starting with a little cat one way, the other way. So as usual, you want to be paying attention to the position of your hands, so your fingers are spread out nice and wide. Ideally, your hands are a little bit wider than shoulder width distance apart. So the cue is here is to align the outside edge of your shoulder with your fingertip, so our index finger. And your index fingers are pointing forward, parallel to each other. Then you can start going back a little bit more. So see if you can feel the stretching again from your index finger all the way through to your shoulders and hips. That will be even more practical for your down dog. And then coming forward, see if you can keep your heel of the hand in contact with the floor, only coming as far as comfortable for your wrists. So we're not going too far, just maybe going a little bit further, just that tiny bit further every round, every cycle. See if you can start to really work with the breath. So inhaling, coming forward, exhaling, reaching back, inhaling, coming forward, coming back to neutral position, warming up the spine as you inhale, curving into the spine as you exhale, rounding into the spine. So pushing your hands into the floor, shoulder blades up to the sky. Inhale. So really protracting the shoulders on the exhale. This will help you for your vinyasas. Inhale, feeling the stretch into the front of the body. Exhale. Couple more like this. Expanding on the inhale, contracting on the exhale. One more, nice and stable onto your hands, coming back to center, inhaling, right leg stretches back. And now see if you can bring your foot out towards the left, placing in outside of your left foot. You can walk your hands out to the side, and then as you exhale, stretch back. Inhale, coming forward, so going nice and easy for this one. We go for a few like this, just to get a little bit used to it. Maybe a little bit tricky, you can go maybe a bit further, touching your hips to the floor, coming back forward, see if you can keep your hands on the floor. Inhale, coming forward, last one, exhale. Inhale, moving your hands back to center, stretching your leg back, and we take the other side, left leg, reaching out to the right, again placing your knee outside, bringing your feet out, walking your hands slightly out to the side, Exhale back, inhale, coming forward. Exhale back. Again, every time, see if you can go a bit further. Inhale, coming forward. Exhale back. See if you can start connecting with your Ujjayi breath. Slow, soft, deep breathing into the back of the throat. And we'll keep going with that as much as possible. Last one, coming back to center, unwind, and then tucking your toes under, and you can start to find your down dog. So again, paying attention to the positioning of your hands, so this will be very important as we move quite rapidly and strongly through our vinyasas in this powerful sequence. Walk, trying to get the balance happening. Soft bend into your knees, you can start to walk your dog for a moment. And we'll start warming up a little bit more seriously, just like we did before, working with the breath. As you inhale, you can come forward to your high plank, chaturanga. Keep protracting your shoulders, and as you exhale, you stretch your hips back and up. Again, you want to be lengthening from your index finger through your shoulders all the way up to your hips. Inhaling, coming forward, nice and strong on your hands. Again, protract your shoulders. Exhale, navel towards the spine, reach back. Inhale, coming forward. Exhale, reach back. We take a couple more like this. Inhale, come forward. Keep protracting your shoulders. Shoulders away from the ears. One last one, working with breath. Exhale, stretch back. Down dog. Stay into your down dog for a moment. Coming forward over your wrist, looking forward, you can step all the way to the top of the mat, lengthening into the spine, halfway lift. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, rising all the way up, palms together. Exhale, you release, hands back down to your heart, and we keep working with the breath, again, in through the nose, as you expand, reaching your arms out and up. As you exhale, folding forward, keep bending into your knees if you need to, fingertips to the floor. As you inhale, flat back again, expanding on the inhale. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, rising all the way up. We'll do three more like this. So you start moving with the breath. Exhale, you release. The breath continues to move. Inhaling, reaching up. So breath never stops, continuous breathing. As you exhale, folding forward, fingertips to the floor. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, you fold, softening at the hip level. Inhale, push your feet into the earth, rise up. We'll take one last one of these before we start to get moving seriously into it. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, folding forward. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, rising all the way up. Palms together. Exhale, release. Here we go. Now we're going to get going. Inhale, maybe start to arch a bit more into the back. Exhale, falling forward. Inhale, flat back, halfway lift. Exhale, you fold, right leg back, moving up into a high lunge, nice and strong, reaching up to the sky. With your arms, tuck your tailbone under. Exhale, you release, clench your hands, chaturanga. Lowering all the way down as you exhale, elbows in close to the body. Inhale, cobra or up dog. Exhale, reach back using your abdominal muscles. Inhaling, right leg up. As you exhale, stepping forward right between your hands. Right arm up, little twist. Exhale, you release. Stepping all the way forward. Inhale, lengthen, halfway lift. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, doing the same thing on the other side. Inhale, reach up, expand into the front of the body. Exhale, soften into the front of the body. Inhale, lengthen, stretch the backside. Exhale, you fold, left leg back, rise up nice and strong. So see if you can find your stability, nice strength and balance. As you exhale, you release, clench your hands, moving through your vinyasa, one breath, one movement, exhaling all the way down. Inhale, look up, exhale, stretch back. Inhaling, stretch your left toes back and up. Exhale, stepping forward. So look where you are stepping. Right, left arm up, coming into your twist. Slowly releasing, stepping forward. Inhale, lengthen, halfway lift. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, rising all the way up, palms together. And we continue three more, or two more like this, increasing the pace. So we start to get a bit of cardio happening. Exhale, falling forward, keep working with the breath. Inhale, exhale, right leg back. Reach up with your arms. As you exhale, you plant your hands, step back, lowering on the same exhale. Inhale, look up. Exhale, stretch back, right leg up. Inhale, exhale, stepping forward. Inhaling into your twist, keep lengthening from your back heel to the crown of the head, you release, stepping forward. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, rise all the way up. Palms together. Exhale, you release. Last one. Inhale. Exhale. I mean, other side. We've got one more after this. Left leg back. Inhale, rise up. Nice and strong. Keep squeezing your thighs together. Exhale, all the way down. Stepping back. Inhale, up dog, cobra, your choice. Exhale, stretch back. Inhaling, left leg up. Exhale, stepping forward. Inhaling into your twist, left arm up. Exhale, you release, step forward. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, rise all the way up. Exhale, last one a little bit faster. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, you fold. Right leg back, high lunge. Reach up. Exhale, maybe three-legged chaturanga this time, lowering all the way down on the exhale. Inhale, look up. Exhale, stretch back, right leg up. Exhale, you step forward. Inhale, twist. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, release. Last side, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, left leg back, rise up, nice and strong. Exhale, maybe three-legged vinyasa. Inhale, look up. Exhale, stretch back, inhale, left leg up. Stepping forward, coming into your twist on the inhale. Exhale, release. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rising all the way up. Palms together. Exhale, you release. Ooh. Bending into your knees, Utkatasana, reaching your arms up. So just in case you're not warm yet, optional, you can either stay there or we'll take a little round of Bastrika breath. Again, pumping the abdominals, rapid in and exhale in and out through the nose. Inhale. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, lengthen, halfway lift. Exhale, you fold. Planting your hands, you can walk back or jump back, going through your vinyasa. One breath, one movement. Exhale, stretch back. Down dog. Looking forward, bending into your knees. The inhale. Walk or jump to the top of the mat. Inhale, lengthen, halfway lift. Exhale, you fold. Bending into your knees, reaching your arms up. We're going to work with the breath again. Now this time as you exhale, you start walking your palms back, chest to thighs. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, arms back. Couple more like this. Inhale. Exhale. Keep breathing in through the nose. Out through the nose. Last one. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, you fold. Plant your hands. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, plant your hands, walk back, jump back, vinyasa, one breath, one movement. Exhale, stretch back, down dog. Inhaling, right leg up. Exhale, step forward, right between your hands. Rising up, high lunge. Opening out warrior two. Flipping your wire. As you inhale, as you exhale, come back to your warrior. Windmill your left arm down, coming onto the ball of your back foot, right arm up for your twist. slowly releasing, presenting your right hand, maybe three-legged chaturanga, going through your vinyasa of your choice. Exhale, stretch back, we take the other side, left leg up, stepping forward, rising up, opening warrior two, flip your reverse. Exhale, right hand down, coming into your twist. Again, vinyasa, three-legged or four-legged. The exhale, inhale, look up. Exhale, stretch back, bending into your knees. Walk or jump to the top of the mat. Inhale, lengthen, halfway lift. Exhale, you fold. Bending into your knees, utkatasana, reaching your arms up. The exhale, you twist to the right. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, to the left. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, you fold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, clench your hands, walk back or jump back. Vinyasa. We meet in down dog. Inhaling, right leg up. Bend your knees, tuck your hips. Nice and slow, the exhale, stepping forward. Rising up. High lunge, this time we're moving into warrior three. Coming forward, ooh, a little bit wobbly, don't worry if it's wobbly, that's okay, just go through it. Find your balance, once you've got your balance. Coming up, trying to keep your leg nice and straight, reaching forward, arms up. Maybe bending into your standing leg. See if you can activate your core nice and strong onto your leg. Getting a bit warm. Slowly coming back, warrior three. Stepping all the way back, high lunge. The exhale, you release, bend your hands. Three-legged, four-legged. Chin stand, if you've got a strong practice, your choice. Inhale, left leg up. Stepping forward, high lunge. Again, see if you can find stability on that left foot coming forward for your warrior three. Nice T-shaped position, trying to keep your leg nice and straight. Rise up. Maybe bending into your standing leg. Keep reaching forward, arms up, very good, coming back, stretch back, high lunge, inhale, doing your vinyasa with one exhale, inhale, exhale, bending into your knees, walk or jump, inhale, lengthen, halfway lift, exhale, you fold, bending into your knees, utkatasana, reaching your arms up, now this time see if you can bring your hips down as low as possible, maybe touching your hands if you can keep reaching your arms up. Slowly releasing. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, you fold. Walking back, jumping back, going through your vinyasa. One breath, one movement. Inhaling, right leg up. Stepping forward, again, high lunge. Inhale, we're moving again into warrior three. And then coming forward, leg forward, arms up. Oof, a little bit wobbly. See if you can find that balance. Then you can bend into your left knee. Number four shake with your left leg. Keep flexing your toes. And then maybe going further, still with your arms up. You can bend into your standing leg. Maybe reaching your arms forward. See if you can bend maybe a little bit more. Whoop, a little bit wobbly. Puffing out, keep going, nice and slow, coming back up, extending your leg. We reverse the whole process, stepping all the way back. Inhale, arms up, going through your vinyasa, three-legged, four-legged, chin stand, your choice. Keep your elbows in close to the body. Inhale, left leg, other side. Inhale, reach up, exhale, coming forward. Inhale, rise up. Again, number four shape. You start bending to your ability as low as possible, maybe reaching your chest to your shin. Arms forward, one more breath. Inhale, come up, unwind. Reach back as you exhale. Inhale, arms up, vinyasa. One breath, one movement. Exhale, reach back, bending into your knees, walk or jump to the top, lengthening into the spine, halfway lift. Exhale, you fold, bending into your knees, reaching your arms up. Now see if you can come to a seat, going into Navasana, bent legs, legs straight. See if you can come down, Ardha Navasana, reaching your right leg up, bringing your arms out to the right. Inhaling, you switch legs, exhaling to the left. Inhale, switch legs, passing through center, exhaling to the left. Inhale, keep going. We've got a few more like this. Keep lifting your shoulders, keep working with the breath. Inhale, center, switch legs, exhale to the side. Keep going, very good. Keep smiling, I know you love this one. And then we'll be going through the obliques, maybe next round. So keep going, legs straight, nice and strong. Last round, to the left, coming back to center, and if you still have some, coming back up, Navasana, crossing your legs, coming forward, you can walk or jump. Going through your Vinyasa, one breath, one movement. Exhale, stretch back, down dog, inhaling, right leg up. Exhale, step forward, rise up, high lunge. Again, just like we did before, warrior three, inhaling, coming up. Now this time we're going to move into Garuda Flow, so crossing your leg completely over, bringing your left arm under, palms together, see if you can bend a bit more into your knee, if you can double hook your legs, that's fine, if not, that's fine. Keep reaching your arms up, keep bending into your standing leg. Nice and slow, you can keep your Garuda Flow arms, unwinding your leg, reaching back, stepping all the way back as you inhale, arms up, still into Garuda Flow, as you exhale, unwind your arms, plant your hands, Vinyasa. Inhale, left leg back, you take the other side, rise up, coming forward. Inhale, reach up, again Garuda Flow, bringing your right arm under this time, get your balance, maybe double hook, keep lifting your arms, relaxing into your shoulders, sinking into your hips maybe a little bit more. Again, we're going to keep the arms in Garuda Flow, unwinding the leg, stretch back, stepping back, arms up, release, plant your hands, Vinyasa. Stretching back, down dog, bending into your knees, walk or jump to the top, lengthening into the spine, halfway lift. Exhale, you fold, bending into your knees, Utkatasana, this time see if you can come onto your tippy toes, and then you slowly start to come down, reaching your arms up, slowly you release, sitting back, again Navasana. Reaching your legs up, chest forward, keep going, very strong, slowly you can start to come down, bending into your right leg, you're going to cross your left leg over, again see if you can take Garuda Flow with your legs, so double hook, can't quite do it, tight hips. A bit more difficult for men as well, but whatever you can do. And then you're going to bring your arms in Garuda Flow as well, with the left arm under. Nice and slow, you can start to release your knees towards the floor, so feet on the floor, and you release your knees towards the right. Sorry, not this one, not just yet. That's a bit too much. we're just going to do a bit more core work. So as you exhale, elbows to knees, inhale, lengthen, exhale, we curl, inhale, lengthen, exhale, curl, inhale, arms up, exhale, to your knees, inhale, one more, exhale, up, now slowly you can start to release, again, bringing your knees out to the side, and then we work into the obliques. See if you can lift your shoulder blades using your obliques, elbows towards your hip. Inhale, release, shoulder blades down. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Keep going a bit more. Inhale. Exhale. This time you can unwind your arms, bringing your arms out in T-shaped position. And as you exhale, you lift up. See if you can lift a bit more and you're really feeling deep into your left oblique. Arms up if you can, keep going. Eventually, maybe one day your knees are going to come to the floor and you keep lifting, so you're getting a bit more into the outside of the obliques. We've got one more breath here. Nice and slow, you release. Oh, knees back to center. Guess what? We've got the other side to go for. Crossing your right leg over. So again, just see how much you can do with the crossing. Getting your Garudasana arms, right arm under, palms together. As you inhale, you lift your elbows. As you exhale, elbows to knees. Inhale. Come on, we've got a few like this. Exhale. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, navel towards the spine. Inhale. Exhale. Oh, I'm sweating. I hope you're sweating. I'm sure you're sweating as well. A little bit more, or this one this morning, a little bit hard, but you keep going. One more. Alright, last one. Release, let your knees drop to the side. Looks like it's a little bit easier, but it's a little bit harder. Different, not really used to the obliques. Exhale, lift up. Inhale, get into those obliques. Exhale, lift up. Inhale. Exhale, don't forget the breath. Keep working with the breath. Feeling the side of the body, right side. We've got a bit more, two to go. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, elbows to hip. Inhale, release. Arms in T-shaped position. Maybe your knees can go a bit further down. Exhale, lift up. And we're holding there. So keep squeezing onto the side of the body. Very good to get rid of excess fat, strengthening the whole body. Keep lifting your arms, keep lifting. So you want to really shorten that side here, just like you want to kiss your hips, or at least your right hip. Keep going, one more breath, and then slowly releasing. Unwind, knees to chest, and you can rock back and forth. Couple of times, then crossing your legs, vinyasa, plant your hands, walk back, turn back, stretch back, down dog, bending into your knees, walk or jump forwards, lengthening into the spine, halfway lift, exhale, you fold, inhale, rising all the way up, palms together, exhale, you release, we've got a bit more to go, inhale, reach up, exhale, falling forward. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, you fold. Plant your hands. Walk back, jump back. Vinyasa, still in control. Exhale, reach back. Down dog. Inhaling, right leg up. As you exhale, stepping forward. Right between your hands, dropping your back knee. We're going to a twist. Maybe getting hold of your back foot, so we're stretching the quad here. Maybe you can go a bit further. You can bring your elbow to the floor. Maybe opening your right knee out, coming onto the outside edge of your right foot. See if you can lean back. Slowly releasing. Framing your front foot, tucking your back toes. Inhale, stretching your right leg back. Three-legged dog, bend your knees, stack your hips. Maybe you can flip your dog, placing your foot behind, pointing all 10 toes towards the back. And you lift your hips, arching into your spine, dropping your head back. Hello, beautiful, nice and slow. You can come back to your down dog. We'll take the other side. Left leg up. Stepping forward, drop your back knee. Coming into a twist as you exhale, maybe you can get hold of your back knee, back foot. maybe coming further. Nice deep quad stretch after the work we've been doing. One breath, slowly releasing your foot, clench your hands, and maybe you can flip your dog all the way, nice and slow in control, still using your abdominals, reaching your hips up, drop your head back. See if you can start reaching your left hand towards the floor, slowly coming back to your down dog, inhaling. Right leg up, we're just finishing off with pigeon pose, placing your left knee behind your left wrist, reaching your left leg back so that you can drop your hips down, hands by your side, taking a couple of breaths here, maybe slight arch into your back. Those who want to go for a king pigeon, you can go for a kick pigeon, getting hold of your back foot, maybe staying there if kick pigeon is something that you feel is good for you, getting a bit more into the hip flexor, thigh on the left side, arching into the spine, or if you feel like coming forward, you can come forward, elbows, forehead. If your arms are stretched forward and you still want a little bit more, you might be adding a little bit of a twist into it, so bringing your right elbow on the outside of your left sole, pressing your palms together. See if you can keep relaxing your shoulders away from your ears, lengthening crown of the head forward, and then twisting maybe a bit further. We slowly unwind, painting your hands, stretching back. Down dog, maybe walking your dog a couple of times before we take the other side. Inhaling left leg, setting up for your pigeon. Paying attention to your knee, again trying to keep your hips nice and squared as much as possible. Drop down towards the floor. Again, maybe king pigeon, or just simply arching back, looking up. Or maybe coming forward. Elbows, forehead. Again, maybe last variation. If you can go for it, you don't have any knee issues, you can go for a little additional twist. Again, see if you can keep relaxing your shoulders away from your ears. Crown is lengthening forward. Forearms should be about vertical. And you can maybe look up, dropping that left shoulder down towards the floor. A few more deep breaths. You can slowly start to unwind. Coming up, lean to your left hip. And just slowly you can swing your right leg around. Very good effort. Stretching your legs forward, nice and slow. We're just going to take one last little stretch. Paschimottanasana, so keeping your legs nice and straight. And you start to come forward, so you don't have to pull on your feet. Nothing to do, maybe just relaxing your hands, forearms by your side, just relaxing into the abdomen. If you have the hold of your feet, maybe you can pull just a little bit, you don't want to be pulling too much. Maybe a good thing to do here is a little massage to the feet, that's always good. So I like to play a bit with my toes, and you can massage in the metatars here, just between, or what leads to in between the toes. You've got lots of tendons here. If you've been standing, walking, or there, they can get sore, so you can give it a bit of a rub, push with your thumbs. If you need to cracking, also I like to crack my toes, so you can do this. You can also do the other way, if you want to feel a bit more stretch onto the sole of your feet. Using your thumb, you can pull one toe at a time on both sides. And as you move a bit further to the third, second, and big toe, it is a bit more stretch onto the arch. You're really feeling it underneath. It's pretty nice. Nice and slow, you can come back, stretching your arms forward. And then very slowly, we're going to move into a quick shavasana just to relax completely for a minute. So rolling your spine down, vertebrae by vertebrae. Legs out, mat distance apart, arms by your side. Ah, very good effort. Relax completely. For a minute or so. Just feel what you feel in the body. That sense of release when it stops. Notice your heart rate, heartbeat, the breath.
Again, you might want to stay for a little bit longer, or maybe you can start to invite the breath back into the body, bringing the breath awareness into the physical body with a little movement into your toes, fingers, still with your eyes closed, maybe rolling your wrists, ankles. Inhaling, stretching your arms overhead. As you exhale, you can roll over onto your left side, taking a few breaths in a fetal position, nice and easy. Just taking your time to come back completely present in this room on your mat. Gently pressing your hands into the floor, coming to a comfortable sit, palms together in front of your heart in the Anjali Mudra. Core should be activated so it's easy to sit up nice and straight. Just really feeling the strength that we've built up into the core, the good stretch. And you can bring your thumbs to the forehead. And we honor the time that we've made for our practice, the effort that we've put in for our practice, for our well-being. And we bow in gratitude to the divine light that surrounds us and resides within each one of us. Hari Om Tat Sat. Peace, love and light. Gently blinking your eyes open when you feel ready. That's it for today. As usual, hope you enjoyed. You can leave some comments and I'll see you in the next video.